Hey guys, welcome back to our repair guys. In today's video guys, we'll show you how we're going to bleed the cooling system on a Porsche Cayenne. Okay, we have that Cayenne for generation 2003-2010 and we'll attempt to bleed the cooling system without any special tools. Let me introduce you that we have more than 200 videos on this car, so please guys subscribe to the channel for more videos. We'll be working here on the 4.5 and we did a coolant pipe update, quite a few videos guys. And what we will be doing today, okay, we do not have the tool to bleed the cooling system and I will not recommend to do that, okay, always get your tool. This is just a fun, entertaining video to see if we will be able to do it without the tool, if we can bleed the cooling system. Now, it doesn't mean that it will work for you, so I don't want to say anything that will ruin your engine, but if you want to see how we are going to attempt it, please check it out. Now, we bought the coolant. Porsche uses they often share the same coolant as Volkswagen and Audi, since it's the same platform, G12, G13. We got the G13 coolant here. You can check out the coolant and the link where we got it from in the description of the video below. That's what we'll be using. This is concentrated, so we need to actually dilute this one. And now, this car has two upper hoses, coolant hoses. You know how the radiator is supposed to have a lower hose right there? This one does, but it comes all the way to the top. So you're supposed to use a special vacuum tool that will get the vacuum out of the system and replace it with coolant. Now, what we will attempt, okay, this hose is where the thermostat is located on this side. So we cannot fill the engine up from here because the thermostat is there. We will attempt to go from this side. This side is wide open and you can check out the video where we replace the coolant pipes, the anatomy of the engine and all that stuff. So we'll go through here, okay, we'll try to put coolant through here, fill the engine up, then we'll fill the radiator, we'll install that hose and we'll fill the radiator all the way up through this hose and we'll see what else we need to do. So make sure you stay with us guys and we'll see if it's going to work out. Now, right here, we're going to attempt to, okay, install that hose, radiator hose, upper hose. Okay, so let me just get this one a little bit tighter, so the clamp will give a little bit more. So let's get the coolant out. Okay, let me see on the back side if it has a table that tells us how much to dilute and all that stuff. Okay, right here, protection coolant water. So if we go 50-50, okay, it tells you Fahrenheit, negative 35, which will be enough for us where we live, it never gets that cold. If you go 60 coolant 40 water, it will be negative 62 and negative 83 for 70-30. And you can see protection against boiling over. You can see that table as well, so. If you want to see the Celsius, it's on this side right here. So we will empty half of our container here in a separate bottle. So we can actually go ahead and mix. We're going to mix ours to dilute it 50 coolant, 50 water. You can see how thick that formula is. Just a little bit more. Okay, let's see now. And ours, it's 1 gallon, 4 quarts, we're right at 2 quarts now. So we'll go ahead and put water now. Okay, so with that hole still open, we're going to go ahead and fill the overflow bottle now. And we'll make sure that we fill it all the way to max. If we notice a leak somewhere, we're going to automatically spoil the hose or something. So this is the first gallon of coolant. This is about so far about almost 4 liters, a little bit less. So we'll go ahead and make we're going to dilute a second gallon now. So we'll keep adding more coolant now. So we keep adding more. You can check your manual for the capacity of the cooling system. So you can see here, we're up to the max. Just even a little bit more than that. So when we went down, coolant came out of this one, always wear gloves. So we'll be ready to install this one now. And we need to go ahead and install it quick. Okay, we're going to actually do it quick. We'll just put it on the radiator and continue with the next thing. So we have the hose connected. You have to make sure that those go all the way in. Okay, that metal piece needs to be in the canal really deep, otherwise the hose is not in. Pull them really hard to make sure that they're not halfway in, because when the car gets hot, you'll kick it out and you'll spill coolant everywhere. So we're going to add more to the max now. Okay, and this is 2 gallons so far. So we'll make some more coolant and we're going to proceed with the next step right now. With 2 gallons, we're at the maximum, you can see. So next, I let that hose down a little bit and the coolant is coming out of it, which means that the radiator is already full, so we're going to install it now on the water pump there. Just to make sure that the radiator is all the way full, we're going to add a little bit more here. Okay, let me see if it's taking any. Okay, let's see if it's increasing here now, because if it's increasing, it means that the radiator is already full. Yep, that's going up. I saw the coolant going up, so that's it. The radiator is full as well. Okay, we installed the hose. Now we need to make sure we get the clamp on there, and we'll continue with the next step. Next, we're going to put the air intake pipe here from the air filters. And we're going to start the car, turn the heater on, and we'll show you what else, and we'll keep eye on the temperature gauge. So, next, for the next step, guys, get the vehicle outside of your garage, because you can seriously poison yourself. We'll need to start the car, let it run, so do that only in the wide open, not in the garage or anything like that. So, we're going to go ahead, start it now, and we'll need to turn our heater on hot, all the way on hot. Okay, so we have the heater here now. This is the fan. Make sure that the fan is on and get it all the way on hot, as much as you can go high. It says high like that. Perfect. Now it's going to circulate the coolant through the thing. Keep eye on the gauge. Okay, on your temperature gauge right here. Ours, you can see it's still on cold. Ignore all the lights. This is because we had our battery disconnected and we need to reset everything. And now while it's running, we'll go outside with the cap still open. Okay, check out how much coolant it took. So we need to add a little bit more now, but do not go over the max mark on the coolant reservoir. Okay, let's check now. We can put just a little bit more. Okay, perfect, like that. Just a little bit over max. Now, we're going to go ahead, close it now, because it can get hot. From that point on, I recommend to let the car idle for a little bit. Keep eye on the temperature gauge. If you smell something like getting hot, turn the car off immediately. Okay, I'll give it gas now. a little bit. Okay, and when the engine starts getting warm, you need to make sure that you start, okay, you start getting some air, warm air from the heater as well. Keep eye on the temperature gauge, and what I'll recommend, just drive around the block, very short distance, less than half a mile. Keep eye on the temperature gauge, let it cool all the way to be cold. Probably let it sit one night and check the coolant level again. If you need, add some. Do that for the next couple of days and you should be ready to go. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos and see you guys next time.